Top 10 Stephen King books that I've read, and I've read most of them. Number 10, Revival, one of his more recent books. Recent, probably it's like 5 years, but I'm getting old, time flies, leave me alone. So this is a really kind of creepy, but mostly it's like a nostalgia-ridden tale. Like once you're getting to my age, and especially older, I would imagine you start thinking back to your olden days. So this one, you really get to go through like a life story with the guy. And one thing that King does really well is childhood stories, and then going back to the childhood stories. So a lot of nostalgia mixed in here with a fair bit of creepiness, some sci-fi elements. Really very, very entertaining book. I was happily pleased. This is when King was like starting to get back in the swing of things. He was probably already in the swing of things by this point. Ninth best Stephen King book, The Dark Half. This is almost like a straight thriller novel. Now it's not. There's a lot of supernatural elements in here, but it really read like a Bachman book, and that would make sense because this is kind of King exploring his Bachman outing, his loss of Bachman. No Bachman. Bachman. Bachman? Bachman. So just a really dark, creepy, gripping, very, very well-paced story, which is kind of surprising because of this era of King's career. And I believe this one was released in the early 90s. This was released in 89. So really around this point, most of King's books were really bloated. This one wasn't. This is just so tightly, fantastically paced. It's just a really good read. So the eighth best Stephen King book, it's On Writing. It's not even like a Stephen King novel. That's why it's called Top 10 Stephen King Books, not Top 10 Stephen King Novels. If you want to be a writer, and even if you don't like Stephen King, and I'm guessing you do like Stephen King because you're on this video, but if you want to be a writer, you need to read this. I've called it the Bible on multiple occasions, and it very much is, it's such good advice, bullshit-free advice. It's just, it's so good. But really, about half the book really is just a biography, a very abbreviated biography, but a very interesting biography. And I love reading authors' biographies, especially autobiographies. Authors do a really good job of talking about themselves. Fantastic book. I've read it 3 or 4 times. If you want to be a writer, you have to read On Writing. It's the law. So, I like fire, and there's a lot of fire in here. Earlier King book, a smaller King book, and it's so well paced. If you're familiar with me, you know one of my, the biggest knock I have on him is pacing. And this book is fantastically paced. It just moves so quickly. It's interesting. You really get to love and care about the characters. The main villain actually changes who the villain is like midway through the book, and then you just like, he's so demented and crazy. She's like, boy, you crazy. And then there's a girl who starts fire with her mind. I want to marry her because I like fire. So up next we have Misery, one of his more famous books. Also kind of read like a Bachman book. I think it was originally supposed to be a Bachman book, and he got outed right before this one. I believe this is the one that he got outed. The main storyline in here is it's so good. It's so good. But there is a book within a book in here where the author, the writer who got captured, has to write a book for his capturer, his prison keeper, his crazy lady. That book within a book, it kind of sucked. And to be honest with you, I skipped it. I didn't read it because it was just really stupid. But the actual straight up main top storyline, it's so good. So good. And the movie is probably even better, just because what Kathy Bates did, really good, like top 10 Stephen King book. Up next, we're kicking it real old school with The Dead Zone. One of his first 5 books, I believe this is actually his 5th book? Might be 4th, I think it's his 5th book. This is a love story. Like, don't let anybody ever tell you otherwise. This is a very tragic love story that puts Romeo and Juliet to absolute shame. Because Romeo and Juliet is just silly little teenagers. This one's not. This one is just, it's such a romantic tragedy, and it makes your heart cry with the emotions. It's really good. Give it a read. So, that one was old school, but how about we go OG, or OK as an original King? Carrie. There's a reason this started his career, launched it, got turned into an all-time classic movie with Sissy Spacek and John Travolta, and I don't know the rest of the actors. I'm not good with actors, but it was a really good movie, and it's a fantastic book. The fact that like a 25, 26, 27 year old guy wrote this boggles the mind. I cannot, like, there's no way in hell I could write a book this good. It's just, how did King do this? It's a tiny book, so obviously it's not bloated. It moves so well. Thank you very much, Tabitha King, for rescuing this out of the trash can. It's a national treasure. Don't mess with the weird kids. Next up, we're gonna take an OT, like the original Travis, the book that I first started doing book reviews on. One of the first videos I ever made for YouTube was on 11/22/63. Now, I love history. This is kind of a history book. It's historical alternative history, I think is the technical term for it. It's so good for like 9/10 of the book. I don't care for the very, very ending, but the very, very, very ending is really, really touching, but the kind of like the round off that I was really looking forward to, the reason that I picked the book up in large part. That one, I didn't care for that. The payoff wasn't good. But the book in general, it's a big book, but every page, I mean, this is just a page turner. The characters, this might be at least tied for the best characters that King has ever done in a book. They're so good. And the historical research that he did is so good. I learned a lot from this book. Now, obviously, when I was like, well, is that true? I had to go do my own research. So it's very, very historically accurate, considering there's a guy from the 21st century that goes back in time to try to save Kennedy. But there's a lot you can learn from this book. Just make sure you verify the facts afterwards. But it's so good. Really, really good book. So I haven't reread a ton of books in the last 10 years or so. I'm not much of a rereader. I've read this one several times though. Just recently I reread it because it's so good. Salem's Lot, it's a big one, but this one moves. This is his second book. And yeah, it's like, how does a guy that's not even 30 years old, or he might have been like right at 30, how do you write stuff this good? I just don't understand it. It's, oh man, so creepy, but like a good creepy. Not like, hey, let's have a child orgy in the sewer creepy, just like vampires that don't sparkle creepy. It's fantastic. I wish they would turn this into a better TV series. They made one back in the 70s, I believe it was, maybe in the early 80s, that kind of sucked. This one would be a good adaptation to do. So like HBO, Netflix, high budget, you want to make a good adaptation? Salem's Lot, right here. Just don't make the vampires sparkle. And finally, the best Stephen King book, to me, is the first Stephen King book I ever read. It. This is the book that started it all for me. This is the book that hooked me, because it has a clown in it, and I hate clowns. Ever since my cousin dressed up as a clown and scarred me for life when I was 3 years old. Thanks a lot, Hannah. Or was it Jamie? I think it was both of y'all. Y'all are mean. Clowns are in here. So, shape-shifting, terrifying monster, childhood. King does such a fantastic job of childhood portrayals. You know, taking you back, putting you in the mind of what you were like when you were, you know, 10, 11, 12, 13 years old, those formative years. He plops you right there, and it's magical. When King goes childhood, it's magical. And then he scares the hell out of you with monsters and childhood shit that's scary. The pacing is actually really good. The structure of the book is kind of complex, but really intriguing. Like the most recent time I read this, I actually paid attention as a writer to the story structure. And I was like, this is really, the way this weaves together for, you know, two different timelines with, I don't know, seven or eight different characters. It's really, really well done. Really, from a technical standpoint, it's just intriguing. And then from a reading standpoint, it's gripping. The only qualm I have with this book is the last, I don't know, probably 80 pages, which is, it's a tiny portion of a big ass book. This book's over 1,000 pages. So I don't care for the ending. I thought it was silly, contrived, stupid, child orgy, giant spider, bad. I mean, when I talk about a cliche bad Stephen King ending, it's this one. But it doesn't detract from the fact that this book is extraordinarily good. It's very, very good. And it got turned into two good adaptations. Tim Curry, you'll always be the Pennywise for me though. Even though, what's his face, did a very good job. But that has been my top 10 Stephen King books. So let me know what you think. What are your top 10 Stephen King books? Are there any books that I mentioned that you actually hate? because there's some that most people would say that are great that I don't care for in the least. And don't forget to at least tip me a like. Let me know that you love me. Make it all worthwhile. So until next time, stay awesome.